Good evening, I'm Jennifer Griswold. After suspending the session for a week, the Nebraska legislature went back to work today. They'll be in Lincoln through Wednesday to pass emergency funds for those battling the coronavirus. Reporter John Kipper went to Lincoln today, where senators are working fast to get the bill through the unicameral and on to Governor Ricketts' desk.
Due to the spread of the coronavirus, 44 of the 49 state senators came back to the Capitol in Lincoln today. And in a unanimous vote, they passed over $80 million worth of funding. That's all going to go towards fighting the coronavirus here in Nebraska.
Things were a bit different in the legislature Monday. Senators in protective masks, hand sanitizer being used liberally, sanitizing wipes given out to every senator present. There was one more irregularity. A huge spending bill passed unanimously with little debate.
Now it's our turn to lay down our partisan politics and pass this bill for the state to protect the safety and well-being of all Nebraskans.
The bill takes money from the state's rainy day fund and puts over $50 million of it towards medical supplies and staffing, specifically going to buying personal protective equipment for nurses and doctors treating the coronavirus patients. The extra money also will help fund COVID-19 testing in the state. Still, there's an additional $25 million set aside in case the state needs more money, and it's just too risky for the legislature to come back to the Capitol. Governor Ricketts said today he believes the money stays in the rainy day fund until he thinks it's needed.
And so that just gives us a little bit more cushion for us to be able to work with during this emergency.
State Senator Kate Bowles of Lincoln has specific plans for that $25 million.
At least from my perspective, should be prioritized for vulnerable populations served by nursing facilities and federally qualified health centers.
Now, while all this is earmarked for specific items, Senator John Stenner says things could change.
It's a fluid situation. I know everybody has been contacted by various people. How is this all going to work? This is the allocation of the dollars. The flexibility is built into this.
Reporting in Lincoln, John Kipper, 3 News Now.